Hey, fellow scientists, Justin here. Mia and I might have overdone it a little. We found out that rocks can teach us all about Earth's history, volcanoes, ancient oceans, even how mountains formed. So naturally, we started collecting and collecting and collecting. Now we have all these rocks, but we have no idea what we're looking at. Right now, they're just, well, rocks. Great idea, Mia. If we can learn how to identify these rocks, I bet we can unlock their stories. All right, scientists, ready to solve the mystery of these rocks? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe the properties of rocks and use those properties to identify them. Let's investigate. We know that a rock is a solid, natural material made of a combination of minerals. All rocks can be grouped based on how they're formed. Do you remember the three types? Rocks can be sedimentary, igneous, or metamorphic. But within those groups, there are actually more than 5,000 specific types of rocks on Earth, like slate, sandstone, or shale. That's a lot to keep track of. But identifying all these different types of rocks can tell us a lot about Earth's history. Imagine this. You find a rock filled with fossils. That rock could reveal that a long, long time ago, this area was part of an ancient ocean full of life. Or what if you uncover a rock with big, wavy layers? That might point to powerful forces deep within the Earth, where heat and pressure transformed it over time. Identifying rocks helps us piece together the history of our planet. But how do we identify rocks when we weren't there to see how they were formed? The answer lies in our powers of observation. Let's take a closer look. Rocks have properties that help us tell them apart, like texture. How does the rock feel? Is it smooth or rough and grainy? Grain is what we call the tiny particles or crystals that make up the rock. Those grains can be different sizes. Are the grains big and easy to see, or tiny and hard to spot? Rocks can also have different colors and patterns. Does it have layers, shiny streaks, or maybe even fossils? Through observing properties like texture, grain size, color, and patterns, scientists can identify specific rocks. A rock's properties often come from how it was formed, so by observing them, we can sometimes figure out if the rock is igneous, sedimentary, or metamorphic. Igneous rocks are made from molten rock, magma or lava, that cools and hardens. The way the rock cools affects its texture and grain size. If the cooling happens slowly underground, the rock might have large, visible crystals, like granite, which gives the rock a rough texture. But if it cools quickly at the surface, the properties of igneous rocks can be very different. Take a look at this obsidian. What do you think it'd feel like to hold? Cooling above the ground can sometimes give igneous rocks a smooth, glassy look. But sometimes that quick cooling process can cause air bubbles to get trapped in the rock. This creates igneous rocks with lots of holes, like pumice. Any of these properties can help scientists identify igneous rocks. Sedimentary rocks, on the other hand, form from layers of sediment. Over time, these layers get pressed together until they harden into rock. This process of compaction can create rocks with a grainy texture or a striped pattern. Some sedimentary rocks, like conglomerate, are made of lots of different sized pieces of rock and minerals stuck together, giving them a bumpy or uneven texture. Others, like zebra rock, can have clear stripes or layers that show how the sediments were deposited over time. Some sedimentary rocks even contain fossils from ancient plants or animals that became part of the rock as the layers hardened over time. All of these properties can help scientists recognize sedimentary rocks. How do you think scientists identify metamorphic rocks? Metamorphic rocks start out as one type of rock, but over time, the heat coming up from the mantle and the pressure of being deep underground change them into something new. This process can create unique patterns like wavy layers or make the rock very dense and hard. This hardness is why the metamorphic rock marble makes a very good material for carving detailed statues without the rock crumbling apart. Now that we know some of the typical properties of the three main types of rocks, it's your turn to try identifying some like an earth scientist. Here's what we know about the three main types of rocks. Take a close look at these rocks. Can you figure out if each one is igneous, sedimentary, or metamorphic? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guide and notes. What do you think? I see this first rock has a fossil of a fish and a leaf. That means those ancient living things must have gotten caught in layers of rock as it formed, making this rock sedimentary. The next rock is smooth and shiny like glass. Igneous rock can look like that when lava cools super quickly at the surface. And this last rock has some cool wavy stripes, which must have formed from extreme heat and pressure, making this metamorphic. Figuring out a rock's type is a great start, but that doesn't tell me exactly what all these rocks are. To figure out their specific names, we can use a special resource called a dichotomous key. This tool guides us through questions about a rock's properties to narrow down what it is. Let's give it a go. Maybe we should start with just one rock. Ooh, this one looks nice. Let's try to identify it using our dichotomous key. I know this might look confusing at first, but once you know how to use it, it's a really handy tool. We just have to take it one step at a time. So we start here. Do we see any crystals? I'm looking for shiny surfaces, but I don't see any, so I'm gonna say no. If we follow the no arrow, we'll get to our next question. Do we see sand grains or pebbles? This rock does look a little grainy. See how it's not totally smooth? Are the grains small? Oh yeah, definitely small. Hey, that means this rock is sandstone. By using the dichotomous key, we have identified that this rock is sandstone. Awesome job. Let's try another. How about this rock? Does this one have crystals? It can be a little hard to tell, but if we shine a light on it, yes, those dark spots are reflecting light. Following the yes arrow brings us to our next step in identifying this rock. Pause the video here and see if you can follow the key to figure out what this rock is. What do you discover? I saw that the rock's crystals weren't lined up in layers, and the crystals are dark. That makes this rock gabbro. Great work, scientists! By observing a rock's properties and using tools like a dichotomous key, I think we can identify anything. Let's review everything we've learned today. Rocks can be identified by their properties, like texture, grain size, colors, and patterns. Common properties help us to identify rocks as igneous, sedimentary, or metamorphic. Tools like dichotomous keys can help us to identify specific types of rocks. To learn more about identifying rocks, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Thanks for your help today, scientists. Now that we know how to identify rocks, Mia and I can get started on identifying our whole collection. Okay, maybe not all of them. You know what, Mia? Maybe we should put most of these rocks back where we found them, but we'll keep a few cool ones to study later, huh? Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! So are you gonna start moving them, or should I? I mean, you're the robot. Just saying. Hey, hey.